In this video, we're going to talk about vertical asymptotes and infinite limits. Now, an asymptote is a line that a curve approaches. So, for example, if you had the green curve here, as you go out the green curve, you get closer and closer and closer and closer and closer to the black line. So you call the black line the asymptote of the green curve. Now, asymptotes can be vertical, they can be horizontal, they can be diagonal. This one's diagonal. In this video, we're going to talk about vertical asymptotes. So how can an asymptote be vertical? An asymptote is vertical, so let's look at the vertical line x equals 2. The way that that could be an asymptote is if the curve gets closer and closer and closer to the line. So that means that the curve has to hug one side of the line. Well, here it went up. It could also have gone down, or you could have the curve approaching it from this side, or you could have the curve approaching it from this side. So there are four ways that you could have a vertical asymptote. Either the function blows up from the left, or it blows up from the right, or it blows up in the negative direction from the left, or it blows up in the negative direction from the right. In other words, you can have a vertical asymptote if the limit as you approach that particular value, either from above or below, is infinity, or if the limit as you approach either from above or below is minus infinity. Now, it's important to remember that infinity is not a number. If you describe this, if you ask somebody who didn't speak English too well what this limit is, they might say, no finish. It keep going. Well, we have a word for no finish. It's called infinity. That's all infinity means. Doesn't finish. It keeps going and going and going and going. So when we say that the function goes to infinity, that means it keeps growing without end. It's eventually bigger than a million, eventually bigger than a billion, eventually bigger than a trillion. When we say that it goes to minus infinity, means it shrinks without end. It's eventually less than minus a million, eventually less than minus a billion, eventually less than minus a trillion. So let's look at an example. Example is the function f of x is 1 over x minus 2. And I claim that that is a vertical asymptote at x equals 2. Because if you plug in 2.1, 2.1 minus 2 is a tenth, 1 over that is 10. You plug in 2.01, you get 100. 2.001, you get 1,000. 2.0001, you get 10,000. And so on. The function keeps growing and growing and growing and growing. And if you plug in 1.99, you get minus 10, because 1.9 minus 2 is minus 0.1. The reciprocal of that is negative 10. Here you get minus 100, minus 1,000, minus 10,000. So the graph looks like this. When x is slightly bigger than 2, f of x is gigantic and positive. The limit is plus infinity. When x is slightly less than 2, f of x is gigantic and negative. We say the limit is minus infinity. That's what a vertical asymptote is, and that's what a limit being infinity means.